Hey everybody, welcome back to the Big Fan Podcast, where you have the two biggest fans in video games, sports, film, and everything else in this thing called life. I am Chase, and always with me is Andrew.
Good to be here.
I'm getting pretty good, huh? That was a good one.
That's pretty good.
That's
clean.
Practice that shit, dude.
Clean.
Practice it. So, yeah, we're back here. Took another week off, because I was on vacation. Little vacay, you know, and we're back at it. Back in the sticks.
Getting ready.
Yeah, getting ready for a wedding we're going to this weekend. Gonna throw down.
Long time friend getting married.
Finally. Yeah, that's crazy.
It's been since kindergarten, I think I've known her.
Yeah, you know her the longest
time. Yeah, long time.
Yeah, because you're around here.
I just grew up in the high desert for so long, you know, but no, I'm happy for her, man.
Yeah.
I'm happy for both of them.
Troy's fucking cool. Yeah, I dig the guy. Really he's cool. Funny. Like, he's funny because it's like complete opposite of her. In the sense of, like, every belief, you know what I mean? Like, but obviously, like, that shit works because...
I mean, look at me and my girl.
Yeah.
Nothing in common, really.
Yeah, so it's just...
Except I have a one part that she doesn't, and it fits perfectly.
It fits perfectly. You know they can stretch, though, right?
Yeah, but, you know, I try to...
Fits perfectly.
I don't think about that.
But, so I'm ready to throw down. I got my outfit tailored to my approval, because I'm short.
Right.
And, like... Yeah. No pants fit properly, like especially the shoes I'm wearing. Yeah. They're made for dancing. There's no heels or anything like that.
They're made for dancing.
I don't know, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, okay, I was like, what did they sell you?
No,
they got you good.
I'm easily upsold on shit, but so that'll be fun. I'm excited.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I have the shoes I have.
Yeah,
they're from when I had my reception.
Yeah,
and my friend who's
been married a long time too.
Yeah, they were supposed to take. My friend was supposed to take back the rental stuff. And he took everything back, but a pair of shoes, like, stayed behind.
Yeah.
And I just kept them. They're, like, really nice, like, tux
dress shoes. Dress shoes.
Yeah.
Nice.
So I don't know if that's going to even go with my outfit, but whatever. I'm going to wear them anyway.
Yeah. I'm excited. Because I'm not sure if you know about this, about me, but I like to dress up. Opportunity for me to dress up, I dress up. Anytime for me not to wear a regular t-shirt and stuff, I will do that.
I love t-shirts.
Like, I've been, like, since I just had a birthday, I'm a year older now. Since I think, probably say when I hit 25, I started getting rid of like the band shirts, the graphic tees. And like, I still have graphic tees, I guess, you know, not like guns and blood, but like stuff on top of it, you know?
Yeah.
And I just have polos and button-ups. I like polos and button-ups.
I mean, it makes you feel more adult.
Yeah, mostly. But like, I'll be like, well, in my class, like, especially today, where I had this teacher today, this semester, who's like, for some reason, always just like, yeah, you millennials. He's like, oh, you this and that. I'm just like, what the fuck? He's like 35 too.
Really?
Yeah. And I'm like, and I was like, you know, you might be. Always like, no, I'm Generation X. I'm just like, whatever, dude. And he just so, anyways. The kids I'm around, I think it was with kids just because I listen to their conversations.
You're like 5 years older than them.
Yeah, you know, I just like, I feel that gap and then like, you know, so I just like, I need polos. I need them to know I'm not one of them, you know, because like, I remember like one time where I was in the office, in the academic office, and there's just these two kids like, fucking like just punked out, you know, punk rocked out, dressed to the nines, patches, everything, and I was like,
punk ass kids.
You know, like, I'm just listening to the conversation, you know, and then they're talking about some band, and they're like, oh, you can't see him anymore. I was like, oh, man, I've seen him a few times. Like, when I didn't say when I was your age. I was like, oh, I saw him a few times, like, back in the day, and, like, fucking cool. And they're, like, their eyes are just, like, they eyed me, dude. And I was just like...
Looking you up and down.
Yeah, and I was probably wearing, like, jeans, and just a polo buttoned up, you know, in a hat.
Sellout.
Yeah, and they're just like, okay. They literally, that's all they said.
Yeah.
And I was just like, okay.
You know what, though? You run into those kids, though, too, like, that just, even if they're totally into whatever you're into, just to be contradictory, they're just like, okay, cool, whatever.
Nah, so
it could have been that, like, okay.
Okay.
Just to make you feel like a dick.
It worked. Yeah. It worked, because I didn't feel like a dick.
Yeah.
I was like, fuck you guys, you know? Like, whatever. But
See, I don't know. I'm on the other side. I could care less of what, like, if I think it's cool, like Rick and Morty. We love that cartoon.
Yeah.
If I see a cool Rick and Morty shirt, I'm going to buy that.
Yeah.
And I'm going to wear it.
Yeah, I want that Little Rick shirt.
Oh, yeah,
I want like a Meeseeks shirt. That was like one of my favorite like episodes.
Because the voice.
We're going to do a... We're going to like... The only thing we really do is carve pumpkins. You know? Like, That's the only thing we really do. Like,
for Halloween.
Oh, so I want to do a Meeseeks, like, stenciler. Like, yeah, I sent you that. Cool, that'd be kind of cool to do that one. But, so what else is up? Update, like, what are you watching right now?
Well, actually, right now, when you first got here, yeah. I was finishing an episode of Heroes Reborn, and it's good so far. It's not, it's pretty slow paced, but it's informational, it's intriguing. They're introducing a whole new lineup of characters. Because before,
people that were in it, are they all coming back?
No, not at all. Like, almost all of them are gone.
Oh, really?
Except for, like, maybe two or three.
Hero,
yeah, that's like the only guy we know for sure is coming back.
Have you seen so far?
We haven't seen him, but they've shown him. They already told you, like, he's coming back.
Gotcha.
And actually, this last episode, they you see hints of him existing.
Yeah.
So, like,
okay.
I mean, it's fun though. I mean, who wouldn't want a world with, like, cool powers and stuff?
Yeah, I remember
having to deal with that.
I remember when I was watching when it first came out. And I kind of got out of it because I think around season 3 or something, I was just like, eh. And then when it was all on Netflix, I just binge watch all the way through and everything. And I liked it. Yeah. I thought it was really interesting. Like, we were talking about when they started getting into time traveling.
Yeah, time traveling.
It was real rough because not only was one person time traveling, you had, like, another person time traveling.
Yeah.
And it was just, it got so, like, there was different, it was so, yeah, it was muddled.
The thing of what I thought about when you were saying that is that, that has to be hard to deal with, because
writing. Can you imagine writing that shit?
Well, no. Like, you have, like, they had, I think, like, 20 some characters.
Yeah.
They all had unique abilities, and then they introduced time travel.
Yeah.
And they had to make it all, like, cohesive.
Yeah.
Like, that's tricky. No matter who's writing or directing it, like, so I think they did as best as anyone would.
Oh yeah, like, it could have been so to the point where, like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
like,
I mean, like, on top of that, like, every season or show has ups and downs, and, like, bad seasons, bad episodes.
TV.
Yeah. So I give them the benefit of the doubt, and, like, you know, it's a rough gig, so.
I forgot it started just because I just forgot to set DVR, but I'll probably try to go back and start it because I was interested. I thought it was cool that they brought it back because I dug the stories and everything. But I think one thing they had an issue with was there was too many players in the game.
It was way too many players.
And then they kind of did what Lost did. They're like, next season, like, forget about what happened. We're not gonna explain that. We're not gonna go down there. Just, we're moving on. And it's just like, it was kind of cool, but it was just like, wait, what the who was that? Like, you know, you know what I mean? So,
well, I mean, what they're doing for this season or whatever, like, they're pretty much saying that there was a shift. They're getting to that shift, but pretty much, like, the ending episode, spoilers, cheerleader exposes that they exist.
Yeah.
And after that, like, people love them, they embrace them. And then there's, like, those agendas where people want to put them away or all that. So what they do is...
some Marvel, like...
Kind of like that, Like, they open this new season up with a huge explosion, and they say it's caused by...
Whatever they call them.
And so, like, everyone goes into hiding because they're being hunted again.
Yeah.
And, like, it's all over, like, tons and tons of people are, like, have powers now.
Yeah. So is it the same thing as a lot of players already? Or is it a little bit constricted? Like, they kind of, like...
No, I mean, there are a lot of players, but they're not all, like, in the forefront. Like, there's, like, only a handful of main characters right now.
Okay.
But you know that there's, like, a big world of them.
Yeah. Okay, that's cool. Yeah. I think I just mostly been watching that Netflix, the new season on Netflix, the American Horror Story. That one's pretty good.
Right.
I've been enjoying that.
I like the first and I think the second one.
The second one was the nuns, like the asylum. Okay.
That's when I did. I fell out of it right there.
Yeah. The first one was bomb.
The best one.
Best one. Well, this actually, I think this is the one. This one is matching up to it. Like it's like for camera, it's right there. It's pretty, not as good as the first one, but it's giving it a good run for its money because the second one, Asylum, was eh.
Yeah.
The Coven Witch one was really bad.
Was it?
Yeah, that one, I didn't like that one at all. But this one's actually, it's good. Like, it has good writing again, and the story's good.
It's the same people, right? Same
actors? Like a good handful of actors are back, all stir in it. And then, I mean, like, we watched one episode last night that was just like, oh, fuck, that's sad. Like, it was just, like, super sad, but good, though. It was, like, a good sad. That was, like... I'm not, no spoilers, but it just goes into one of, like, the mentally challenged, deformed, actual real people they get in these shows. Remember? Oh, right. Because they actually get, like, challenged. Yeah. They get some, you know, really challenged people in these shows. Yeah. And, like, acting and everything. But, like, it's one of these characters, and something sad happens. You get
a bunch of Gilbert Grapes.
Yeah, dude. And, like, not even just Gilbert Grapes. You get, like, deformed Gilbert Grapes. Yeah, dude. Like,
it's not, like, prosthetic or...
No. You actually get, like, they're one of the... In the season, they have the world's smallest woman in the... And she's, like, this little Indian woman, like, who's just, like, this big. And she's just, like, chilling. Like, just picking her up. Like
a mini-me?
Like the whole... remember Dr. Monroe, whatever's island?
Yeah, I love
it. It's one of those. Not so messed up, but, like, yeah. She looks like just, like, a little girl, but she's, like, a woman. Just, like, this little Indian girl.
Not that many people know about that movie.
That's a creepy-ass movie. I love that movie. That movie used to give me nightmares when I was a kid.
Yeah, same here. I used to get creeped out, but I used to falling asleep watching that movie.
Yeah.
It was just so fun. Like,
yeah, it's a good movie. That shit, when you're young, yeah. Gave me nightmares.
Gave me
dude.
Ideas. I'm like, dude, I want like my own mutant.
I want to be a cheetah.
Yeah, I want to be like half bear.
Yeah, all right.
Whatever I want.
It'd be fucking badass. But I've been watching that, and now that like I said, mentioned Rick and Morty, the season ended. And it's so sad too. Like, my girl's all like, she gets into it. She's like, that's fucking sad. Like, she's all sad and shit. You know, Rick is in prison. You don't give a fuck, but I think I'm breaking out.
That's not gonna last.
Yeah, exactly. But that's so crazy that like we're getting to the point with animated like cartoons, especially adult ones that are
really adult,
really well written, where it's just like, fuck, that's sad. You know, not just insanely smart, funny, but like emotionally, like, you know.
It grabs you.
Yeah, grabs you. So I can't wait for that next one.
You said you started Flash.
Yeah. I just started.
You started from the beginning?
Yeah, very beginning. Okay. They just added it to Netflix recently. Okay. And I tried watching the Green Hunter.
The Green Arrow.
Yeah, and that wasn't for me. Couldn't dig it. It was too soapy. But this actually is... I had to go to class. I got to pause and I had to leave. But I'm sold. Like, I'm digging it.
I mean, he makes a couple appearances in The Flash.
Yeah, I that whole Marvel TV, it's...
Well, that's DC.
That's DC? Okay, my bad. I was getting confused.
I mean, Marvel has they have Agents S.H.I.E.L.D.
S.H.I.E.L.D., that's what
I'm saying. And then Miss Carter.
Okay. And they, like, entwine their shit.
Yeah.
So, that's the thing is, like, I listened to one of the Smodcast podcasts with Kevin Smith being Batman on Batman, you know? Yeah, who's Kevin Smith? But on Batman on Batman, that's mostly how I get a lot of my geek news.
Sure, yeah.
Because he and the co-host, they just slam out a bunch of stuff that, you know, it's like, oh, cool, I didn't know this. But they always say where DC is killing it on TV and how Marvel kills it on movies. And it's just like how Marvel does it on movies. They just kill it. And they just intertwine all the shit. And, like, DC is just like Batman. Yeah. And then a Superman, like... And then now they're finally, looks like they're entwining, you know, Batman and Superman coming out, and like, why not throw in the Flash? And like, it's just like, you know what I mean? So it just seems like DC.
Yeah, because Marvel has, like, the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. show, they actually do entwine their stuff with the movies.
With the movies, yeah.
But DC is totally separate. Like, they're not even getting the same Flash.
For the movie, I
kind of made me mad.
I was just listening to one of the most recent Batman on Batmans, and they're saying like it's a whole different Flash.
I've seen them too.
And that's the thing. Like, I don't know what it looks like, but
I like Barry Allen from the TV show. He just fits it, in my opinion. Like the look.
They were saying the same thing. They're like, why don't they do this?
I mean, they could use him and change the story. Who cares? Like, change his attitude.
Yeah,
but like, just keep him.
It's just so weird because they're saying like they even brought it to like. A capitalist idea, like standpoint, in the sense of like, okay, we want to sell toys.
Right.
Why? So like, let's say you have a father or mother buying toys for their kids. You have one Flash and another Flash, and it's all confusing. It's just like, I'm just gonna buy Iron Man because that's Iron Man.
It's got a mask. It doesn't matter who's.
They know who it is, but it's like when you have two Flashes, it's just like I don't want to buy them the wrong Flash. You know what I mean? Yeah. So it's just they brought it to that, like not just like, oh, keep it. They're like, let's talk. Went towards like a money
talk toys
point, yeah, and they're like, how does this make sense? So that was kind of weird too. But
or even like newer comics with, you know, how they maybe wants to adapt their faces or
it's just gonna be confusing. Maybe I mean it's not even in like developments, so maybe
that's true,
something happens. But I was digging so far. Like, I liked it how it was just like a little intro backstory, and they just jumped into it, and I was like, cool.
Yeah, they keep feeding it to you little by little, which is good, because
I like the story, because his mom dies, and it's just like, it's weird and cool, so, I've been digging it, so, we're back at it again, little update to you guys, life's good.
Yeah,
life is great. So you wanted to bring some updates of some news of like tech and science.
Oh yeah, let me pull that up real quick.
What you got for us? As you guys know, we're not just fans of movies and stuff. Fans of everything. You're joking in the background.
That's my man right there. Oh man. Okay.
What you got?
The first one I was going to talk about or bring up is an article that I found about NASA. They created like a lightweight material, and it kind of looks like. What are you doing? Oh, you're clicking the camera.
Yeah, it was like.
It's like it's a very lightweight material.
Yeah.
They say it's the thickness of 1,000 times of our hair, like just that thin.
Like the fiber.
The fiber, like the tube of whatever it is. Yes,
yeah.
It's that. You know, it's very thin. But it's 100 times lighter than styrofoam.
The styrofoam is already like pretty damn light.
Yeah, 100 times lighter. But it's like super, super durable, lightweight, strong. They're saying like they can use it for like.
You said it was as strong as steel.
Yeah.
That's what you said. It was as strong as steel.
Well, I mean, because they can applicate it. They kind of fold it onto itself. You know, and just make it as strong as they want.
Kind of. Okay, I get it. It could be as strong as steel, but they can also make it as strong as wood.
Yeah, but they said they did this, like this test where they threw an egg outside like of a window, and it landed on a pillow of it.
It was weird,
and it landed; it didn't break.
Oh, 25 cool.
stories. They threw an egg on it. It kind of just like it like absorbed caught energy.
It landed straight up.
Just perfect.
You know how like it's
like
straight
a
up.
A chicken hatched instantly, and they fought that chicken.
That's crazy.
But like, no, I just thought that was cool.
You think that's like when I hear stuff like that, like I think like obviously NASA. You know, developed it so it can go into like their space program, and whatnot. But I automatically go towards like military development.
Yeah, that's where they get the money from.
Right? Oh, exactly. So it's just like, oh fuck, this is so cool because this could like benefit our. Because like I'm so for space exploration. You know?
Definitely.
Like I believe in our army. You know what I mean?
But I mean, like, they do exist.
Yeah, no, I mean, I believe like we should have a standing force.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Yeah. But I believe all the countries we have, we don't need them there.
No.
You know what I mean? We don't need them. So if we just took that, that's billions of trillions of dollars. We took that out. You know, we just had a standing force, maybe in the surrounding Americas. But
defense.
Like, yeah, just defense. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That can go to our space program, and then like
it once again, a lot of things.
Yeah, but I'm saying like just for now, space, and we can like go to Mars now and like start doing shit there. You know what I mean? It's just like
what do you think about that whole idea of going to Mars, and you know it's not the air's not habitable right now, but they would it's called terraforming it, where it turns their atmosphere into our atmosphere.
Fucking dope.
Which sounds cool and everything, but
money.
But the biggest question is why can't they just redo that here? If our atmosphere,
fuck Earth.
Yeah, it's like our atmosphere is getting tore up. I don't know if you've seen China's pollution.
Oh, it's horrible.
You can barely see.
Yeah.
Like a foot in front of you.
So gross.
But like everyone's like, why don't we just terraform another planet? I'm like, no, let's terraform ours again. Like this fix ours.
We fucked up. We're done.
I guess. Done. That's true.
Like, did you see that one thing where
I think it was the UN.
The UN said that like America, you can't start taking over planets. Like it was something like that. They're like, you can't start claiming land.
Sure.
And it's just like, try us. You know,
like, dude, have you heard of those companies that are trying to claim like meteors and like all those things flying because what they want to do is because I don't know if you remember they was a big deal probably a couple months ago where they landed a rover on a moving
asteroid. Yeah.
And it was like huge because that's hard to do. It's going like hundreds of miles an hour.
Oh yeah, it's rotating.
And they successfully land it. And what fucking they want to do with that
Armageddon shit right there, dude.
Yeah, pretty much.
Ah.
But what they want to do with that is they want to do that, replicate that on different asteroids, and then mine them.
Because
some of them are made of pure diamonds. Some are like
some are just
lithium, like
unknown. Yeah.
So like people are trying to claim their country, their company.
Yeah.
You know, highest bidder kind of thing.
I'm all for it.
Yeah, why not?
Fuck it, why not? Because, like, in my opinion, it's like, it's so, like.
It creates competition.
Competition for one, which I'm all for.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And, like, it goes into capitalism, but it's like, not even that, that just forces us into space more. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, even though maybe I'm not going to space, it's just forcing us to go to space, and then, like, Russia's gonna try to do that shit. It's like, all right, Russia, like, we're done. Fuck, we're done paying you. We're gonna do it. You know,
we beat you once.
Yeah, we beat you once. We're gonna do it again. You know, like, because I know, like, from right now, we pay them to take our people up there.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's just like, if we do this competition, it's just like, maybe, you know, we should have seen that.
Yeah, their program is still way more active than ours.
Oh yeah, yeah, because our funding is just ridiculous right now. Yeah.
Well, I mean, what do you think about like deep sea exploration? Like, we still don't know what's down there.
Way, way deep and some of that.
Like, they say less than 10% of our ocean is explored.
Yeah, I think it's boring. Not for me.
Really?
But I think it's boring to like.
Oh, to
the
like,
majority.
Like the headline.
Yeah, like because like I mean I know like they can find so many like maybe like undiscovered material or minerals or whatever, you know.
Creatures.
Yeah. Hey, creatures too, but it's just like, I think that's boring to the majority. Like,
sure.
We don't know what's out there or there, you know. Yeah. Like, I think that's more fascinating and, you know what I mean? Plus, it's that, maybe that it's that escape from our planet to like, what's on that planet? Compared to like, fuck the ocean.
I've already been here.
Yeah, fuck sharks, you know what I mean?
Everyone go to the beach.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, I'm all for it. Like, I'm all for new discoveries. Like, I just saw today, they discovered like a snub-nosed monkey that's like, they just found in like the Himalayas or some shit like that. I'm like, that's cool. Like,
and that's on land. Like,
yeah, yeah. So it's just like, what's in the deep blue? Or the deep black blue?
I mean, because a lot of the medicines and stuff that we get now, like the herbs and like that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, it comes from like the ocean.
Yeah.
And they have so many medicines that we haven't discovered yet.
No, so, I'm all for it. I think it's cool.
It might be like a super weed.
Yeah, right?
down there.
Like, so it'll fuck you up. Yeah. Like, I just listened to this one podcast. It's actually pretty interesting. It's called 99% Invisible. And it's about like more kind of like architectural stuff, but
like building architects?
Not really. Like, the one I was listening to was about the very first I forget what it's called, but it's about the very first sphere thing that they created to go down deep below. Like, I forget what that's actually called, but you've seen them in movies, like in the Titanic, the sphere, and they go down for deep pressure and everything.
Yeah.
And it's about the very first one where it was like two guys on this like no bench. They're just like kind of sitting on the ground and they had like two spotlights, and it was just like they went down the deepest. And this is like in the 40s or some shit like that.
Now, you know who went down the deepest now? The director of Avatar, what's his name?
Really?
Yeah.
Fucking David, not David Lynch, what's his fucking name?
His name's slipping me too. Why?
Yeah, I don't know. He's a douche.
How's he a douche?
I don't like him. He's a douche, dude.
Dude, he's pushing the limits.
Because he made Avatar, that's why.
You don't like Avatar?
No, I don't like Avatar.
Why, too preachy? That's the point.
Hell yeah, it was way too preachy.
That's the point.
Why? It's just like, people with bows and arrows versus guns. Like, no shit. Since the dawn of time, people who have evolved and adapted for better. Like, that was dumb. Oh, fuck it.
What about just the pure director and engineering and the special effects of that movie?
Oh, that was cool. I mean, I dug that, but like the story,
it's a story.
Nah,
it's like Indians versus cowboys. Like,
yeah, it was just like shit happens.
Robots and aliens.
And Romans and witch mahadgets, you know?
Witch mahadgets.
Yeah, whatever.
Those witch mahadgets.
Yeah, they got blankets now or something. Yeah, but he was the deepest.
He's gone the deepest, and he spent tons of money to build his own little personal submarine.
What a dick.
What a douche.
What a dick.
And he went down there. He went deep.
Why? For Avatar?
For his own thing? For a bunch of,
I know he's, like, proactive and, like, shit, like, in the ocean, like.
What a dick, huh?
Yeah, he's a dick.
What a tryhard.
Does he, like, was he one of the, like, the whale? Like, he would stop people from killing whales? That's someone that's a fat dude, huh?
Mm.
I'm getting my people mixed up.
They're both white. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, they're probably all white. Fucking white
bet.
People.
That's a safe bet. He's white.
Fucking white people. But
anyway.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm all for deep sea, you know, exploration.
You know why they use a sphere?
Because of pressure. It bounces like there's
the
no
strongest.
Shape. Yeah, yeah, like it's equally distributed.
Yeah.
Boom.
Science.
And word. Yeah.
We know stuff.
Yeah, so I learned that from 99% Invisible. Oh, yeah, okay. They like, I think I've heard that before, but that's how I found out. That's like, oh, okay,
confirmed.
That's
theory. Yeah, confirmed. Yeah,
that's interesting, but yeah, so something else I saw in the science world, I thought it was fucking interesting and funny because I was in class and I was just kind of going through headlines, but I was reading it and it's this new thing scientists have developed in a test where they can test your saliva to see if you're gay.
Sounds promising. I don't see any issues with this at all.
Like, it's just like the funniest thing. It's just like, I have many questions, right?
Yeah.
So, like, first one's like, would you take it?
Yeah, I take it.
I dig it.
I mean, going out of my way, getting my card.
Yeah, I take it.
Just to take
it. Just to take it. Because it's like...
If it's more than an hour away, hell no.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, this hypothetical, you can take it. It's down the street, Lavatore, you can take it, right? Yeah,
sure, I guess I take it.
So you've been married for 5, 6, like 10?
6 years.
Six years now. Obviously, you're heterosexual, right? You love the ladies. Maybe. So, like, what if you take it? Like, yeah, you're gay. Next. You're like, wait, what do you mean? Yeah, wait. Like,
100% gay.
Like, you know what I mean? So, it's just like, yeah, you're gay.
Slap me in the face with a paper.
Next.
The results, yeah.
Like, it's just like, it's just so funny. It's like, no, I'm not. Like,
but I like vagina.
Yeah, and so it's like, how, like, reliable is the test? Because, like, what if you are gay? You just got done sucking a dick.
Sure.
You have dick saliva in you, and it's just like to swab you. Oh, you're heterosexual. Like, you know what I mean? Just mind blown.
I would say there's flaws in their test. That's what I would say. Like, yeah, definitely.
I was cracking up because I was thinking about all the different, you know, scenarios that would go through.
Did you see any comments that thread?
Oh yeah. Well, I got a lot of my news from the Fox News Channel.
You did say that, yeah.
And not only because of that, I love the comments section.
Oh yeah.
Like I said, I don't brag, but like there's nothing to brag about. But I lean more right in the political world. You know, I don't believe a lot of their like big things that the right wing believes, but I believe more of that. Then, anyways, I love the comment section because the comment section is real far right conservative, and those are the best comments to read. You know, like
there's pretty much I can give you an answer. You can if you want to have the right answer for conservatives, is Jesus.
Yeah.
In America.
Yeah.
And you win.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all you gotta say.
It's a good shit. So the comments on these were pretty evil and mean and everything. Some of them were funny because it's just like, you truly believe this, right?
Yeah.
It's just so funny. They're like, stop swabbing this in our kindergartens and right away. Like, just like, why?
Who cares?
Who cares? Yeah. So a lot of shit like that. Just like, you really want kids being swabbed? But I don't know. I thought it was
confusing,
so funny. And just also like, why do we need to know if someone's gay? Gay?
Yeah, who's taking the time to like
you gay?
Draw this scientific study up? Like, who's we need to figure this problem out.
Like, why is this a problem?
Because many people are coming to us not knowing if they're gay. So we gotta
We don't like that.
We gotta tell them if they're gay.
You're gay, you know that? Yeah. Like, yeah, I do know. Yeah. Okay, as long as you know.
Those people who say they choose.
I doubt it. Yeah, so I thought it was just so funny. It's just like, why does this even need to be a study and test? It's funny because it's just like, what, like, I would like to take it. It's just like, oh yeah, you're gay. I'm like, no, I'm not. It's just like,
show me your tits right now. I'm not gay.
I'll fucking grab them, you know?
What about you?
But yeah, so that was the thing I saw in science was, I was like, cool, we're getting places. We're
moving on.
We're really moving on in the world where we have to swab people and like let them know. Like, it's also people walking in like, I just don't know if I'm gay or not.
Yeah, some people just don't know.
Like, dude, take a dick and you find out. Go with the girl, scissor it up and find out. Like, fuck taking a test, just do it.
Yeah, let's get
if you're
done.
If you're in
it's like a bandage. Just
yeah,
get
if,
it over.
If you're in unsure, take a dick. It's my motto.
And I'll be there.
I'll be there too.
I'll be there.
But yeah, so
one more.
Hey, what you got? What you got?
One more cool little, kind of like it's a mock up.
Yeah,
but it's a cool one because it kind of ties in with like our biggest love movies.
Yeah,
well, one of them anyway.
Yeah,
and it kind of draws from the movie The Martian where.
Yeah.
The guy gets stuck on Mars,
yeah.
And he's forced to like figure it out how
he's
to live.
He's like a botanist.
Yeah,
he's a botanist.
He's a bot man.
A bot man.
And so what they did, like he has to figure out how to make food, right?
Yeah.
It's different from that, but what this mock, like test they did is they created a system that allows like hydroponics to grow the food without without any soil, which is where you get the nutrients for food.
Yeah.
And it uses like, because they just discovered Mars has water.
Yeah, that's cool.
Like different types of water too.
Yeah.
And, like as far as like where it freezes or not.
Yeah.
And so they could use that. And it says it takes, use artificial light and reuses some of the water that it can drain from outside.
Okay,
and it uses that nutrients to...
It's like an ecosystem.
Yeah.
Or something like that, right?
And then just from that, just keep using the heat that it generates and like all that.
Plants generate heat and oxygen.
And oxygen. So it's good for everything. And
That's fucking cool.
They actually made a cool looking like little, like, I don't know if you can't see right now, but a little like...
Tubes.
Like a bunch of tubes network. It just looks like tube stars. It actually looks like those little rat tubes.
Yeah, with the hamsters. The hamster tubes. Yeah.
Oh, that's what we're gonna.
But right. I think that's cool because I read the book The Martian, and the cool thing was like, because it's based on, you know, a little bit in the future, you know, obviously because they're sleeping, hypersleep and whatnot, but the whole interesting fact was that he figured out a way to grow potatoes in Mars, or at Mars, whatever. And the whole thing with sci-fi, I actually learned recently, compared to fantasy, where fantasy is fully fake.
Yeah, fully fake.
But sci-fi, it takes like possibility that could be from science and technology and advancements. Like, this could be a possibility. Not
like
just
Star Trek. That's
exactly. Yeah, Star Wars, all that stuff. So, like,
well, not really Star Wars.
Hey, we could have laser swords pretty soon.
No, force.
We don't know.
I know that.
You see the Pope?
Yeah, it's true. He is a magician.
He makes people bow, dude.
That's true. And he just uses...
Yeah, he's just like...
But he also kisses people's feet.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
And washes them.
You get away from my feet, dude.
Yeah, he's got a foot fetish for sure.
Fucking fetish fucker. But, so I think it's interesting that that they were doing that in the book, that he was able to grow potatoes. Yeah. So even bringing it back to Earth, wherever we're having issues, like in China and whatnot, like people can start growing food and everything in different ways. And... When we drove up to the Bay Area recently for a vacation, when you get through like Tehachapi and like up in the Five area, you see a lot of signs for farmers saying like, "Water, we need water." Like, politicians are the blame for this. Like, water comes, what grows your food? Water, you know, stuff like that. Because farmers are taking really the biggest hit of the drought here in California compared to you and I who go to the store. And there's a revolving door with endless water compared to out in the farmland where they actually need water. But we develop systems like that, and like somehow these farmers are able to start growing again, or, you know, all this stuff. But
that'd be cool.
That also goes into that whole other, like, there's a documentary where like a big, in a pie chart, a big chunk of farms are owned by these big companies.
Huge companies.
That just grow this type of food.
Particular crops.
And they use all these fucking sprays and all this stuff. And it's just like that they make and all this stuff. So, I mean, it goes into a bigger...
It's a big web.
It's a big web. Yeah. But if I think maybe this changes that web. I don't know.
It could.
Yeah.
It could.
That'd be kind
of
interesting.
I know, you know, there's the fear in the future of overpopulation.
Well.
And, but China. I mean, China's got, like, a few good ideas. I think they've already started doing where they use the vertical skyscraper method.
Fucking Jetsons, dude.
Yeah, like, they're skyscrapers of just food.
Growing. Like, oh, okay. Where that was just people. I'm like, earthquake.
No.
Fucking, that's brilliant, China.
I mean, same thing could happen with the food, too, but...
Yeah.
As far as
that's... So what do you mean? Like, just building, like, a big skyscraper?
Well, instead of having,
food?
Like, a ton of land... To grow food, and like they're running, you know, the land is getting more.
Oh, kind of like a big mall, but it's just like growing food.
Just food.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
Like,
that
just
makes
straight
more.
Up into the sky, like just food, layers and rows of food.
I guess that's smarter than, you know, large, because they don't have it.
Yeah.
Large, you know, spaces of land that you need for food where your population is out of control. But that's crazy shit, though.
But plus, that would also help clean the atmosphere with the plants and all that jazz.
Oh, yeah,
like,
because...
They filter, kind of.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Especially if I don't think anything really can grow out there.
Yeah, that's true. I don't
know. They can't...
Something's got to give first. Yeah. It's either the smog or the food.
Yeah. What if, like, we created, like, some sort of, like... We call it, like, virus bomb? What was that? I don't know what they call it, but maybe it's a virus. I'm going to call it a virus bomb.
Okay.
Somehow we blew it up. I'm not saying we should do this, but like, I think it's like, this is almost a possibility of conflict where we develop some sort of virus bomb where we blew it up, and because China's air so fucking polluted, it somehow the molecules change that air, because it's like
nanobites?
Yeah, some shit where like, because like in just that constricted area, all of a sudden like just people are dying, and compared to like once that virus bomb spread out, like it just died out because the air is not so polluted. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
oh, like it takes it out?
Yeah, because it's just like, oh, like we don't know who did it. You know what I mean? Like, it's fucking gnarly. So, I don't know. Something good. Watch the conflict. I don't know.
I mean, there's gonna be so many conflicts coming up in the next, I think, 10 years.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Most likely. Yeah. Well, stand by Israel, people.
We're so positive here, you know? That's what we do. We bring the positive news to everyone. So,
okay. Well, yeah. I love fucking science.
Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah, so that was our science bit,
I guess. Science corner. Speaking of corners. Speaking of corners, I'm going to start a segment.
Sure.
Chase's corner.
Sure.
All right. Chase's corner, you ass.
You have things to say.
I have things to say. And you know me. I'm pretty cool. Laid back. Pretty easy going. That's great. But there's a couple things that are bigaboos to me. Not jigaboos. That's bad. That's bad. A bigaboo.
Okay. Right.
And is there like things that just get my
that's,
goat?
That's close.
Yeah, it is close. But I think, I don't know.
I think everyone knows that they're both bad.
Yes, they're both bad things. So anyways, what's your opinion on drive-through ATMs?
I think they exist. I think they're...
wham, bam, boom, right?
They're sort of convenient because they're supposed to be quick and easy. You're in your car. You don't have to get out. You post up.
Deposit, withdrawal,
and you go.
Check balance, right. Go, right? So
for most.
For what you should be fucking using. Yeah. So, pull around, and then right in front of me is an old guy who's not only parked to the side, who parks, turns it off, opens the door, gets out, is at the ATM.
Yeah.
He proceeds to fucking 8 times, I see him take the card out, put it back in, enter his PIN, hit things, confuse, ejects, puts back in, enter the pins. 8 times, dude, I counted this asshole. And I'm just like, what the fuck? About time he gets out and drives away, he parks. I pull up, put my card in. I'm trying to make a cash deposit. It says unavailable. All these things are unavailable. Okay, this shit's down. Withdraw my card, go inside.
Yeah.
Fuck, dude. What the fuck, dude? You had,
read.
Read. Yeah. Don't keep trying, asshole. Yeah. It was 8 times.
Maybe he can't. Reading.
No, he's old. See. Maybe he can't don't see. Use the ATM, old man.
Well, just that, but he shouldn't be on the road, probably.
Oh yeah, most likely because he was in front of me online.
Yeah.
And this is my second thing, but he was so old with the lady who was like, "Sir," she had to go all the way in front of him, like, "Hey, I can help you over here." He's like, "Oh, I'm sorry." Yeah, I was like, "Are you?"
She got out from her booth.
There was 2 people behind the desk, and then, sometimes people in the counts area, do it.
Okay.
Well, she was on the side. She's like, I'll help the next person. Uh-huh. He's just like, her.
He's looking at the ground.
Just look at the ground. So she gets a little bit closer. She's like, sir, I can help you. Her. You know, like, finally gets in front of him. Like, hey, you know. He's like, oh, I'm sorry, you know. And I can go there. Yeah. Well, because the people in front in the actual banker area in the front were taking forever. So, you know, she started bringing people in. My second issue are lines. Not lines that, like, let's say you're at an amusement park or going to PSX. I understand those are lines.
Mm-hmm.
But for, like, lines at, like, bank tellers or the fucking restaurant.
Like doctor's office.
When you're fucking just taking forever, do something else.
Step aside.
Step aside for people who are, like, literally, like, okay, I just got to sign in. I'm out of the way.
Yeah.
When people... or just there.
Checking their phone.
Fucking, yeah. Because one of the aisles was just like... And also, like, it's not just the customer. It's the people that are like, sorry it's taking a while. You know, but we'll have more people out here. Like, even at grocery stores. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When you go to a grocery store, there's 2 aisles. Yeah. And you're like, what the fuck? And then, like, finally someone would come.
Yeah.
It just... shit like that gets me, dude.
Or, like, grocery store, but, like, the... I'm glad we don't have to deal with it anymore. No. But, like, movie rental places... You're like, oh, I don't know if I do it. What about that one over there? They're in line. They're pointing over like...
get the fuck out of line.
Oh, what's that movie over there? Is that brand new?
Yeah.
You know, how the rating... You know, what do you think about this one?
I think it's a piece of shit.
Yeah, like, just, who cares? You have what you have. Get and go.
So, my thing is old people and just lines. Like, fucked up line system.
Yeah.
Okay? Like I said, I understand when there's lines for amusement parks. You have a large quantity of people want to do one thing. There's a line. Yeah. But just systems, broken system lines, bug the shit out of me, dude. Like, I might not even be in a rush. No, but I'm in a rush now because you're pissing me off.
Yeah, now I'm in a rush because I'm impatient with you.
Yeah, oh, dude, I was...
But I think, honestly, like, I'm not kidding around. Like, I do think there should be a number that you can call. Kind of like how you can call the number for, like, if you think there's someone drunk on the road.
Yeah, for old people?
For old people.
Oh, dude, that was fucking...
And they, like, drive up, they inspect, like, they give, like, some kind of old person test to see if you're coherent.
Who's the current president?
Yeah, if you can drive, like, make you do, like, a little, you know, like, almost like a mini DMV test.
Yeah.
They're scary.
Because I travel a lot for school. I'm driving at least 100 miles a commute for school, right? I see a lot of shit. I feel like I'm a confident driver, not cocky, just confident where I can see the 3 moves before it happens. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I'm just driving, I'm aware.
Anticipating.
And it's just, there's so many times where I'm just driving, I'm merging, but I use a lot of blinkers. I'm a blinker. I think I've talked about blinkers.
A lot of people don't.
And I've had old guys just like, and I'm just like, horn, I'm checking if I can cut over, you know what I mean? Yeah. I'm just like, and I'm like, what the fuck? He's like, what?
Well, what's going on?
What's going on? We're going.
It's just Tuesday.
Oh my God, dude. It's just, I had something actually today where I don't get like aggravated in my car, but this is my motion for blinker. Like, use
why?
The, it's right there. Like, use the blinker.
You
should
go like this.
Yeah, like, I don't know. I'm getting kind of
this
mad.
Is like, you toot your horn.
Good job.
Pull your horn. Like,
but,
like, I don't have a Tucker horn.
Not
here,
a Tucker.
Sir. Yeah.
But, like, today, like, the freeway's messed up because one of the lanes, a couple lanes are closed. And I don't like when people just like, yeah, I'm merging. Like, use a blinker. Because not only are you merging, the trucker behind me is merging. The person in front of me is going slow. Like, lady, like, when I can go back up, I'll let your ass in.
Are those people like, they hit the blinker like they're halfway over?
Oh yeah, it's just like,
like, well, you need at least like a second blinking, and then.
Because I'm one of those people that will back off so they can get through. Like, I'll let people through.
Yeah, sure.
I'm a good guy. I'm a good guy. I'm really in.
When you're not in a rush.
I'm not in a rush, but that was something today that was just like, ooh, especially that old fucker at the ATM 8 times.
That's crazy.
Why? And then he's like, just the whole like, huh? What?
Maybe, well, you know what though? When you're old, maybe you're just so used to like,
why aren't failing, you working?
No, trying and failing at technology.
To the point.
Like, well, maybe if I just do it again, it might work. Like,
I guess that, because like, one of my jobs.
Man, I have a lot to deal with.
Oh yeah, fuck, right? You know, he was gross too with all his skin and everything.
Skin?
But yeah, it was
disgusting.
It was gross. Like, he was just bleeding and shit
always,
like that. Yeah,
shedding.
Always bleeding.
Shed
yeah.
like a lizard skin, just shedding skin.
But yeah, so that was. That's a segment I'm bringing in because I have a microphone and I get to say my piece.
Do what you want.
But yeah, so Chase's corner.
Damn.
Yeah. So okay. So this is something I wanted to talk about though. We have Halloween. We have Thanksgiving.
Halloween.
We have Christmas coming up, right?
Yeah. Holidays.
Holidays coming up. As I get older, I'm just like, fuck. You know, like.
I'm old.
Yeah. Fuck. I'm old. Fuck the family. Yeah. I getting involved in. But that's me though, right? Yeah. You yourself, do you want to explain a little bit or?
Sure. So me and holidays was a little different than most people. Believe it or not, I grew up a Jehovah's Witness.
Yeah.
And that being.
Sorry for cursing. I should microphone.
Hey, you jerk. Anyway.
Yeah.
We don't celebrate holidays. Yeah. We don't celebrate anything that's considered a pagan religion or like a meaningless holiday.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not heathens or pagans.
Pagans.
And birthdays fall on that, Halloween, Christmas, like all the goodies.
Fucking
quote unquote.
I always thought that was like the oddest one out of all of them. Like, fuck Christmas, I believe that. You know, fuck this and that. But like, birthday is just like, because me, like, I'm narcissistic, but I'm like, yes, celebrate my birth, fuckers. Like, be
see,
happy
me,
that you knew.
To
me,
like, as a kid, that one made the most sense not to celebrate.
Really?
Yeah, like, why? You just were born. Like, you didn't do anything.
See, like, I'm the opposite. See, I'm like, yeah, celebrate.
But
that
why?
You all knew me.
I never understood
like,
that.
Thank you. It's not for me. I feel like everyone else should be thankful
that I'm in their life.
I'm in their life for another year.
I guess.
Not in like the thug life way.
Don't
like,
you do that all the time, every time you go out to like have dinner with them or like you hang out with them and not celebrating it? No. No, you need like a day.
The day is my
like,
day.
You need a title on your day. It's my day. Like a wedding.
Yeah, exactly. So, okay, anyways.
Anyways, so growing up, like we never had, like I said, no holidays.
Yeah.
So I'd see people dress up and it never really bothered me because I was used to it already.
Yeah.
But there would, because I grew up loving horror movies, like hardcore horror movies. Like, my favorite topic, like, genre by far
is horror.
It'd be horror comedy.
Horrors.
Horrors comedy.
Like, horrors.
And so, like, I grew to love, like, creatures and, like, cool looking effects.
Yeah.
And I was like, man, I wish I could dress up. Like, I didn't even care about celebrating. I just, like, the.
Wanted to dress up.
I just wanted to dress up.
I know all about that.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, whoa. I think you need that swab test. Anyway. So, like, I'd want to dress up like Freddy Krueger or, like, the Wolf Man. That's, like, my favorite scary monster is a wolf or a werewolf, anyway. Werewolf?
So good.
Anyway. So, like, I see that, and I get kind of bummed out.
Yeah.
But over time, I got over it.
So, I have questions, because, like, when you're a kid, it's like, oh, we're trick-or-treating, it's candy. Oh, candy, you know?
Yeah.
So, for you, was it not really candy? Just like, I don't want to fucking be a wolf. Or did you want the candy?
I want to be a wolf. Yeah, I mean, of course I wanted candy, but, I mean... I didn't care what it came from or why it was being handed out. Okay. I just wanted candy.
Yeah, okay, exactly. You're a kid. Like, yeah. I just want candy. I just want candy. So, like, are you like, wait, I gotta dress up? Like, I don't get, like...
No, well,
I kinda, also, like, you guys are idiots. Just buy the candy.
Well, that's what we did.
Right?
Well, like, it's on sale. Like,
we just buy the candy.
Buy the candy. So, that's what I ended up with. Like, can I get this bag of 100,000 candies for $10?
Assortments, yeah.
She's like, yeah.
Because I always think,
so
too...
So, I always got what I wanted.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I always think, like, With J-Hos is like
over.
But it's like you're on the outside in, like, idiots, just buy the candy.
All right, you don't have to go door to door to strangers' houses.
Yeah, yeah. Because I remember like going, because when we grew up north in the suburbs of the Bay, you just go door to door. I remember like the old weirdos with, like, you know, they would give you pennies. My mom was like, throw that away, that's weird, you know, we don't know what that's laced with. Or like the open cookies, like, throw that away, that's weird, you know.
Definitely nothing opened.
Yeah, nothing open. I remember like a couple of old people were like, they would give you like these little like packaged toothbrush and toothpaste. Like, okay, fuck you, you're a dick.
Yeah.
I'm here for it. And it's just like, it's just so weird, but it just makes, like, exactly, like, I always wonder about being the outside looking in, like, why? But then, like you said, you kind of want to dress up as a wolf.
Well, just dress up. Not necessarily just a wolf. I just want to dress up.
And just,
I wanted, like, to scare people,
too. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, because, like I said, I was really fascinated with special effects.
I thought you say fast. I'm like, where are you?
No, like, special effects.
Yeah.
And, like, because my favorite scary movie, American Werewolf in London.
Yeah, that one's cool.
That transition. Good soundtrack. That transition of being a man to a wolf was like the best by far still.
Yeah.
Werewolf, not a wolf. Anyway.
I gotcha. Yeah.
So, like, I just, that captured my imagination. Yeah. And like Jurassic Park, like all that cool animation and all that. Yeah. But, so yeah, I just wanted to be a part of that. Yeah.
See, I'm a downer when it comes sometimes to like scary stuff. When it comes to like, we went to Knott's Berry Farm, or Not Scary Farm, they call it, during Halloween. Yeah, I went to that once.
Oh, right.
And I was tanked. Yeah. I told this in the podcast already? Yeah. Okay, so it's just like, I'm just like, you get people like, stop it, drunk guy.
Yeah,
you're ruining the fun.
Yeah, you are.
That's like, it's funny to me. I mean, like, obviously, the people I was with, you know, shenanigans and whatnot, but it's just, you know, doing the job. But no, like, I dig Halloween. Like, I'm a big pussy when it comes to scary shit.
Really?
Especially scary, real areas.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I've been to, like, some sketchy areas. I'm like, I want to go home now. Like, yeah. I want to go home now.
Let's
go.
Let me ask you this. Yeah. It's, I forget who brought it up, but it's, like, so obvious, like, right in your face.
Yeah.
Talking about ghosts.
Yeah.
And, you know, when they go ghost hunting and all that.
Yeah.
They go to these old castles or whatever.
Yeah.
Or cemeteries.
That are overnight.
Hundreds and hundreds of years old, yeah. Right? And there's, like, these ghosts have been there for so long, whatever.
Yeah.
But why is it...
Whatever.
...that none of the ghosts are younger or new?
What do you mean?
Like, say this house was built in 2005.
Yeah.
If I died in it.
Yeah.
Today.
Yeah.
When if ghosts are real, whatever circumstances that cause a ghost to stay there.
Yeah.
How come no one goes and investigates new ghosts? Like, they're all old.
I watch Ghost Adventures a lot, not because of the show. Not because of that douchebag Zach.
Or, this is funny because it's so stupid.
It was. I like the bald guy because he had cool reactions. Like, oh.
I wish he practices.
It was funny. Yeah. But it was mostly the stupidity. And they're like, you see that?
You hear that?
And like, I was of the white dots. Like, you see this? I'm like, get the fuck out of here. Like, and there's energy leaving. That's my favorite one. There's energy leaving. It's just like, get the fuck out of here. And then they have like those talk boxes where it's just like, help. Help. And it's just like, get the fuck.
And but, wouldn't that crap be on the front news if it was legit?
Like, yeah, I mean, like, I think we both agree, like, or maybe me, I'm a big, like, sucker and, like, love of stories, of these scary stories.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if people, like, because
true
I'm,
or fake, I don't care.
Yeah, I'm not a disbeliever or a believer in ghosts just because I've never encountered it. I've never witnessed anything weird or extraterrestrial or anything like that. So I just, like, my mind is just that way where I just, you know... But when I hear people's stories, I'm like, oh, shit, yeah.
Gives you chills, huh?
Yeah, dude, it gets me into it. But, it's just so weird that, like, there's never really, like, there's a baby boy here just died last month. Yeah. He walks around the halls, you know, just like.
Why can't a baby walk?
Yeah. No. Was the dead baby ghost. But, I don't know, like, so, like, I was, you know, Halloween's coming up, you know, right?
Yeah.
So, I don't know, that was, so what's scary movies that you would recommend?
Me? Well, like I said.
Three.
American Werewolf in London, the movie It,
Yeah, dude. It. Besides the ending.
Yeah, it's horrible.
But
they all float. The story was so good.
They all float. Georgie.
They all float.
Dude, good movie. Good that movie used to fuck me shit. Fuck me shit up.
Fuck me shit up. And then.
The clown. Damn. Pennywise.
There's so many good ones back then.
Yeah. But yeah, oh, it's a good one though. Gremlins.
For diversity, I'd probably go with The Shining.
Yeah.
Just because it's a
mindfucker.
Yeah. Or The Exorcist.
Yeah, the first one.
Classic.
Yeah.
Special effects.
I like when she walks down the hall and just pees.
Yeah.
Just like.
You or even dummy. Even the first Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah. That was good. That was
terrifying. Because it's so realistic. Like it can happen.
Yeah.
And that was terrifying. Because where we grew up in Lucerne, that's us.
Fucking nut job.
That's us out there.
Like people coming into your
property. Speaking
of
Lucerne.
Yeah.
That was another thing about growing up during Halloween. Like, where are we going to go door to door?
Oh, yeah. Like, I remember,
really an option.
I remember when we moved to the area, they're like, no one trick-or-treats around here? No. What the fuck?
Where are you going to come from?
Well, we're going to go to some fucking rapist house because half that area is fucking red dots of
they open the
child
door.
Molesters.
You open the door, it's like a meth lab in the background.
Yeah.
And they're all cooking.
We're busy?
Yeah. Hello. We're going to blow up if you don't disturb us. You know?
Something to add to that list. It's not an old one, but I think I've talked about it. I like it a lot because if you go in with just enjoy the movie, was Fourth Kind. It's not ghostly. Right. It's more alien. It's alien.
It's the feeling it gives you.
Oh, dude, that movie,
pure
like
story wise,
it didn't like scare me in a sense, but it was just like whoa, fuck, that was intense, and yeah. it was like especially at towards spoiler at the end when she's like fucking possessed by the alien. It's like the talking and everything. Yeah. It's just like oh, chills.
See, I only watched it once.
Yeah.
And I always. Interpreted it as like, well, because I want to watch it again, but what I took away from it is it could be the like there's extraterrestrial, there's demons, hypothetically, and then there's like the physical or whatever, and then there's like the fourth kind or whatever, and I think like what is that, like something in between or something we interpret as being one but really it's the other or vice versa. Like maybe
the fourth kind of them was like the different types of encounters for them. It was like first kind is like the fake corn croppings, and then second kind was like, oh, I see
you. But what I'm saying is maybe we just were, maybe certain people were interpreting those as demonic, and the other half was interpreting as alien.
I gotcha. Okay. You know? Yeah.
So it's kind of like
fucking creepy.
You read what you want to read.
Yeah, exactly.
It is what you think it is.
People afterwards, they chew that movie apart. They're like, that's fake. I'm like, show the fucking Paranormal Activities.
So
but they love that shit. Yeah. They love that. They still come out with Paranormal Activities.
There's another brand new one. I just saw the previous. Like, they're turning.
Don't you hate when it's scary movies where it's the dark night vision? You see people screaming in the movie theater.
That's one of my pet peeves.
Right? I hate that.
I almost boycott a movie, even if I'm really interested in it.
When you see that?
I'm like, nope. They
no. That is a screening room, and they're like, hey, we need you guys to do some shit. We're just going to film some reactions. Get the fuck out of my face. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I think if once or twice in the movie, I kind of jump. I was never like, come out.
We'll fight you.
But I've never done that. It's always just like a movie trailer where they show that. I'm just like, no.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or when they're laughing.
Right. Right? Either one,
They don't tell me when to laugh.
Yeah, I'll laugh when the laugh track tells me to laugh.
So Halloween, that was more of a thing where looking in, it wasn't really like
I think
not missing much, because I'm assuming like pumpkins were out of it and like that.
Yeah, this is the thing. We still did the pumpkin thing, but
the day before.
No, we didn't carve or anything like that.
The day before, the day after.
Nah, we bought the pumpkins because they're in season.
Yeah.
They're cheaper, but I love pumpkin seeds and pumpkin pie.
I like pumpkin pie.
No, I love pumpkin
like,
pie.
Like apple.
Yeah.
Or like like a key lime pie.
Yeah, I can get down with that sometimes.
Or like a lemon pie.
That's a little too strong for me. I like the taste.
Too
it's
sweet.
Just a little too strong.
Too sweet. Too lemony.
I can take like a few bites.
But not really even a pie person or a cake person. Like, like ice cream.
Ice cream good.
Ice cream good.
I like ice cream.
Yeah. Pie, I'm like, what? Bread and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Which I get down on a sandwich. But like,
going off on a tangent here. You just name it off. I like water. I like ice. But no, so like we get the pumpkins.
Yeah.
I gut them out. We'd like make, we'd like fry up the seeds with salt.
Yeah, I like that stuff.
Some sea salt on top.
Yeah.
Snack on that. Go snowboarding, whatever.
Yeah.
And then we.
Why?
What?
You lost me on to the snowboarding part.
That's just what we did during the winter.
Okay, okay.
But yeah, we'd make pumpkin pie, yeah. You know, we'd do all that. But that going door to door was never, like, it was never, like, in my face.
Yeah, sorry. Okay, so I grew up with that. Yeah, but in that area, this area, I guess
you wouldn't really. So, like, that plus.
Do you guys get it here? Or you guys, because you got not even this little area?
We've been here for, like, 5 years. Nothing.
Really?
No, I don't, like, one time I accidentally left the light on.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, shit, I got to turn the light off. Yeah. Like, I don't want kids coming here.
Yeah.
And no one came still. Like,
oh, wow. Because when I grew up north, because the reason I ask is when I grew up north, our neighbor to our right of us were Jehovah's Witnesses.
Yeah.
And I remember going around the street, house to house, blah, blah, blah. Their house lights are off. And like, candy.
Give him right there.
Give him a candy. I remember, like, not, like, we used to, like, play when we were kids and everything, but, like, you just know when, like, houses don't participate because they're just dark and just like fuck off, you know. I just like, come on, my candy though, you know.
That's fair. I mean,
yeah, but or my favorite is when they just had the bowl, like, be honest, like, yeah, fuck you.
Who's like, that's the dumbest thing ever.
No,
be honest,
yeah, I'm taking your bowl with you, you know.
I'll return it the next year,
yeah, right? I'll see you next year, dick.
But I do have a story. So, I mean, this is probably 2006. Ish.
We graduated.
Oh yeah, we were graduated. Okay. It was after high school.
Okay.
And
it's a shenanigan story?
No, not really. Well, kind of. But it's just an experience that I had.
You're being on the inside now.
I went on the inside.
Went on the inside, dip your toes.
Yeah.
So fucking heathens.
It kinda started off in a few ways. One, I just wanted to try it.
Yeah.
And
what's a wolf?
I was not a wolf.
It's a wolf.
Not wolf.
Yeah, but Joseph is a wolf. I went full wolf.
I fully transformed.
And, how funny would that be if the story was like, so, I bought some fur stuff. It just was a wolf.
I just patched it all over.
I just
myself.
Went door to door. Was this even Halloween? No. This was September.
It was a regular day. This was right after I graduated.
I'm a wolf.
I took off my gown and there was my wolf suit. Yeah.
I'm partaking in this. Alright, got you.
But, so what happened? Oh, yeah. So it just so happened that, like, a group of my friends at the time, from, like, BBC or wherever, they're like, yeah, we're gonna go trick or treat. I'm like, you're, like, 19, 20 year old.
Yeah, I don't believe in older people doing it.
Well, whatever. That's whatever. But.
Because older people in my neighborhood were dicks to the kids.
Well, that makes sense then.
Leave us alone. We just want the candy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty much all we wanted. We wanted to go trick-or-treating just for the candy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which, you know, whatever. So we'd, like, you want to know my first dressing up thing was? Yeah. I was a crump dancer.
Was it just blackface?
Kind of. Like,
yeah?
Kind of. But it was, I had, like, this giant blue jacket.
Like a fur, windbreaker?
Like fur.
Oh, okay.
Like, you know.
So part wolf man.
Kind of wolf. I'm almost a full wolf.
When a wolf crunk dancer.
And we like painted my face like you know, I don't know if you've ever seen like crump dancers, like they have a weird painting on their face.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. Because I remember seeing a movie.
Yeah. Crump. Something. Crump the yard.
It probably was something probably like that. Was. And like they would paint their faces. Yeah.
So we did that. Like wore a hat and all that. And we all dressed up like that. We're like a dance crew.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was just an excuse to get candy.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And we went to Spring Valley Lake.
Yeah.
All the rich guy people were.
Yeah, yeah.
We like parked our car like way at top of the hill and we just walked.
Yeah.
Miles.
Yeah.
To run. And we got like maybe only like a handful of candy. Like there was no one handing out candy. Like my first time I got like.
Because my experience in this area is people go to places like shopping centers and shit like that. Or like,
oh, okay. So
you know what I mean? Yeah. Like they go to like places for some reason to do it. Like I know there's small neighborhoods like, hey, let's be that neighborhood, you know, for our kids.
Yeah.
I think they mostly get along, you know, those communities. But yeah, my experience in this area is like they go to like shopping centers and shit like that. Alright, go to car to car, which is even more like lame.
Yeah.
Like
it's not
stay away from the van, obviously.
It's like not even the same type of it's not the same ballpark, really. Yeah. It's just creepy.
Yeah, exactly. Don't go to the van because okay, so that was your first time dipping your toe. Oh, more?
I think it was either that same year or the next Halloween. We're living in Lucerne and I had to move from that Lucerne house.
Yeah.
And we pretty much gutted everything out of that house except for like a couple sofas and this giant beanbag I have right here.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about like we took the copper pipes and shit. No. Okay, well, full blown.
No, not like that. Just empty like the furniture and like our personal stuff out. And I ordered two kegs.
Yeah.
I was like, let's party.
Dang.
Two kegs.
Yeah, this is Halloween?
Yeah, it was around Halloween.
Okay.
And I wanted to have like a Halloween party where people dress up and stuff. Yeah. So like my outfit, like, of course I like waited till last minute.
It'd be funny, it was like another adaptation of a wolf again.
It's not a wolf. And I was like, this is something quick. I was running late. I was like, I'll just grab something. Went to like the cheapest Halloween store. I grabbed Dr. Feelgood.
Okay. Doctor uniform. Yeah.
And I made my girl be a sexy nurse kind of outfit.
Okay.
And we partied. So like I knew.
So hard.
I knew probably 5 people there.
Oh, really?
And it was over 300 people.
That's my anxiety right there.
See, for some reason, I was like, fuck it. Like, who cares?
Yeah, like when you're in the dragon mode, but just like...
Well, no, plus I was like, I don't care about this place right now. Like,
oh, because you were moving out.
Moving out. Like, at the time, I was
mad. That place get thrashed?
I was mad at my dad.
Yeah.
And it was this place.
Oh, shit.
I was like, I don't care what happens here. Like,
don't give a fuck.
As long as there's no fire or anything crazy, I don't care. Like, I know they're going to change the carpet, so whatever.
Did it get messed up?
Dude, it got tore up.
Oh, really? Yeah. Man, and it was people.
And, okay, so we did that, and I still hear stories. Like, my friend I met, he's like, dude, I went to this party in the store, and I was like, that was my house. But he didn't even know, because we probably didn't even see each other.
Because you're Dr.
If we walked outside my door, there was just, like, parking, like a Costco parking lot of cars. And we did, I was like, we have...
How'd you promote that shit?
I didn't.
Just word of mouth?
Just word of mouth over maybe a day.
Wow.
Yeah.
This is, like... MySpace days too, huh?
Yeah, like technology wasn't that advanced. Yeah, yeah, like, yeah. Yeah, to really be word of mouth.
That's dope.
Or calling.
Like, yeah, not really actual texting, calling. Yeah, actual calling. Yeah.
And we still had like a whole keg left. I was like, let's do it tomorrow. So we
did it again.
We did it again.
Dang, same amount of people.
Same amount of people. Fuck. And then we did it one more week.
Same costume, Dr. Feelgood?
No, I didn't wear it again.
Okay.
That's the other thing that pissed me off. Not like only like 3 or 4 people came in a costume.
Yeah.
You know, people. Well, it makes sense because people heard about it last second. And it was like, oh, just go to the party.
The party and everything. So do you, like nowadays as an adult, respectable figure in the community.
Sure.
Do you, like, have you guys gone to any Halloween parties or
nah? Nah.
Like, invited to?
Yeah, I've been invited.
Is it just like, nah, because it's Halloween? Or like, nah, because I want to party?
Both.
Yeah. Really, yeah. Okay. I was wondering. Yeah.
Because, like, I mean, it depends on who's inviting me. Yeah. Really. Like, if I know them.
If I invited you.
Maybe.
No.
Well, it depends where, too. Like, me, like, it's where, who.
My living room.
What time.
Yeah.
Because I got to be in bed.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm fucking old now.
But, yeah, I don't know. So I experienced the taste of it, and it's not the same. It's not the true experience that everyone
gets. If it was just a party, would you go to? Or if it's because of a Halloween party, you're like, eh.
I don't know.
I like, tried it, kind of liked it, don't really like it.
Yeah, exactly.
Mouth.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. I'm curious. Yeah, mostly. Yeah.
No, a lot of people don't know like what it was like to...
Yeah, looking in, but I mean, looking in the glass and just be like, dummies.
I do imagine it would be a lot harder if I grew up...
Now?
Just like somewhere with a real neighborhood. Oh, you see it all the time.
Yeah.
You know, and because... And like,
as a kid, you're like, Ghostbusters guy. Look at that. He's a wolf.
That's the thing. Growing up, like being a fan of like Ninja Turtles, Ghostbusters. Oh, yeah. Like I want to be that. You know, like I want to be a part of that. Yeah. Like, anywhere.
I never had really cool costumes.
No?
No. Like, I think 1 year I was Michael Jackson.
No way.
I used to be a huge Michael Jackson fan when I was a kid.
You were like, blackface? Or just stay the white?
Just white.
You were the white. You're like teenage Michael.
Yeah, no, I was I was teenage, yeah. But like when I was a kid, like I actually had like my I got like calls from like, this is like kindergarten area, you know, like that time period where the teacher would call home and like, we have an issue with Chase, you know, he's not responding to Chase. Wants to be called Michael. Because I had a little jacket.
So you're psycho.
And it's just like, call Michael then. Jesus Christ. That's Michael Jackson. Like, I did the same thing with Arnold because Terminator 2. That was like my favorite movie.
Yeah.
I thought that's, you know, by George Thorogood, Bad to the Bone. I thought that was Arnold singing it. And like, so I had the same leather jacket from Michael Jackson era. And I just was like.
And then you spray painted it black to be Arnold.
Yeah, yeah. And like, it was funny because like, we have an issue with Chase. It won't be called Chase. It won't be called Arnold. Like, call him Arnold. Jesus Christ.
Was this the same year?
No, I don't know. I don't know. Maybe like a year after. But this is like all kindergarten, preschool, first grade. I kind of remember first grade, but not really. But so I remember being like, you know, the Terminator 1 year, which is no like thing. It was just a leather jacket and cowboy boots and, you know, kind of thing. And I was Michael Jackson another year. And like, I think it was a turtle, Ninja Turtle one year. But then, like, after that, I kind of forget shit. And then I remember just being, like, a skeleton, like, thing. And, like, I have a chest that, like, you pump and you see blood come through. I remember having that just, like,
you know? Doing it over and over
again. Yeah, just because, like, it was just a mask. And, like, your chest was, like, you like the inside cavity of your body. It was just, like, blood pumping. And I just remember doing that.
It was a nightmare for your parents to clean up.
Oh, no, it was, like, inside the plastic. Like, it was, like, a plastic shield thing. You just
It's like a pump. See-through thing you can
see. And it's just all, like, you know, red liquid. And then, like, I don't remember much being after that, really. And so I just remember those. So I didn't really have, like, the cool costumes we see today, I guess, where people are going full out and everything. But I think the only thing we're going to do is, like, she wants to do a pumpkin. Like, I like, well, actually, I don't do it. I just tell her which one I want, and she carves it. Yeah, so
that's probably what I would do.
She's like, she's like, did a whole, like, you know, I kind of want to do pumpkin patch. I'm like, all right. She's like, I know it's for kids. I'm like, we can go to one, whatever, you know. It's not really hot, you know. Just, all right, we'll get a pumpkin.
You know what I do want to do?
Yeah,
is a maze.
Yeah, like, those are pretty scary. Yeah, because, like, especially the ones that pop out of you and everything.
I don't care. Even if it's just regular, do a maze. Just a regular maze.
Want to beat it?
Yeah.
Help!
Help over here. I'm gonna ask. Do we get a flare? Do we get a flare gun? Because I'm gonna need one.
Like, I think plant. I did one corn, like I think it was a hay maze. I think we did hay maze ones. I remember the kid was freaking out, and the dad had to help push the kid over the hay because he was freaking out and everything. So they knew they were at the wall area, and the guy just, like, pushed. What are you yawning in my story? He pushed the kid outside of the maze because he was freaking out and everything, and I was like, sucker. But, because it was a hay. It was a hay maze, you know?
Oh, okay. It wasn't, like, a hay field.
No, it was a hay, like, actual hay bales. Okay. And he had to, like, push the kid up, and he had to climb somehow, you know.
Was he getting claustrophobic or something?
Something. The kid was probably, like, a downy or something like that. I don't know.
Jesus.
I don't know. But, yeah, so...
Holidays.
Holidays, and, yeah. I don't dig them as much now. It's more family.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not really...
Save a lot. I know you save a lot of money, though.
That was the other thing. Like, save a ton of money.
Save a lot of money. Just, like,
instead of spending money on a costume, I got way more candy.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And just, like, even like the Christmas stuff. And as an adult, like, why buy each other, everyone presents?
Yeah.
Why just buy yourself some new shit?
You keep your money.
Yeah.
And not wrap this crap. Like, let me just do what I want to do and get the day off.
Yeah, yeah, exactly, right? Yeah. So, awesome. Yeah. I think it was a good one. It was a goodie. Good. A lot of topics. So, once again, you can find the podcast on iTunes, Stitcher. It's on there. You can just go to the website, bigfanpod.com, and just stream it from the website. You can download it off the website for free. And then...
you check out our YouTube channel.
YouTube channel, yes.
There's some rough videos. There's some technical issues, but...
He's trying, people.
We're doing it. Like, it's...
He's... I'm sorry.
It's my fault.
But I hope you guys enjoy. And always on Twitter, bigfanpod. At Grizzly Chase. I'm a little more active these days now. And then
I'm at Juggernaut81.
Juggernaut81. And then if you play PlayStation, you can find us both. I'm Bear Uden.
You want to spell that out?
You'll find me. Bear. And then J-E-U-D-I-N. Because I had to spell it weird because they won't let me take Uden, like the real way. But yeah. And then you're Juggernaut81, right?
Yeah, on PlayStation. With 3 G's. Not because I'm trying to be cool.
Yeah.
Not trying to be a triple G.
Yeah.
Triple OG.
Triple OG.
It's just what was available. Okay. But so yeah, Juggernaut 81.
Yeah, so
8140.
Okay. 8140, 1111. But you can find us on PlayStation, play games with us online.
That'd be cool.
Smash them ass on Madden.
Ash smashing.
Ash smashing. And until next time, have a good week.
Bye bye.